నమస్కారం. డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ సార్వత్రిక విశ్వవిద్యాలయం విద్యార్థులకు స్వాగతం. ఈ ప్రసారంలో
hello students, today we'll discuss about the quantum statistics. What is exactly quantum? If you look into the Latin terminology, the meaning of quantum is I did the best. So I did the best to the statistical mechanics. How the quantum mechanics is helpful to understand the statistical mechanics, we just look into today's class. So quantum statistics is nothing but as study of statistical ensemble by using quantum mechanical laws. Before going to the detail into the quantum statistics, just let us look into the main statistical quantum statistical postulates. If you recollect the quantum mechanical equation, a wave function psi can be represented by in ket notation, that is nothing but as a Dirac notation, you said ket psi, which is equal to summation over Cn in phi n. What is Cn? Is a constant, and phi n is a linear compositions or linear summation of all the state vectors under Hilbert space. So, this vector can be represented by this Cn square is nothing but as probability of the wave function. In according to quantum mechanics, any physical variable can be represented by an operator. This operator can be represented by a average notations, that is average q can be represented by psi q psi. It is clearly as given that ket this is operator q is equal to can be represented by psi q psi. Then this is the statistical mechanical representation where the Cn is nothing but as a probability. This probability is a function of time. Now this postulates has derived into two parts. One is postulates of equal a priori probability and postulate of random phases. Then the Cn. Now in quantum mechanics, this operator can be represented by any physical variable. Coming to the statistical mechanics, this Q represents an ensemble. Ensemble, the word ensemble as defined by the Einstein, it is nothing but as a collection of large number of particles. Now in quantum mechanics, the average function can be represented by a physical variable. In statistical quantum mechanics, the same thing can be represented by an ensemble. So ensemble represents clear picture of the state. In coming to the postulates, the Cn, nothing but as inner product or scalar product is equal to 1. This is possible if and only if the energy level lies between E and E plus delta, otherwise becomes 0. Coming to the random postulates of random phases, here we have Cn comma Cm. So if n is different to m, then which is equal to 0 for all n is not equal to m. Now Cn, where Cn is a constant, which is a function of time. Now Cn can be represented by Cn bar in statistical mechanics. In case of quantum mechanics, we generally don't represent Cn comma Cn. So now Cn is exactly equal to Cn bar. To understand more about the quantum statistics, these quantum statistics divided by three categories. One is Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, Bose-Einstein statistics, and Fermi-Dirac statistics. Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics can be represented by a kind of classical, and Bose-Einstein statistics, if particle obey the Bose-Einstein condition, then you call Bose-Einstein statistics. If the particle obeys Fermi-Dirac laws, then you call Fermi-Dirac statistics. Now, Bose-Einstein statistics and Fermi-Dirac statistics both are obeyed by quantum laws. Now Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, these are the pictures of the Maxwell and this is a Leonhard Edward. We'll look into the what is a Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics. Now in Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, particles are distinguishable. Now for example, let us say you say particle states can be represented by 1, 2, 3 and we have particles are A and B. So then the particle states can be occupied by 3 square is nothing but as a 9 position, therefore you are getting kind of 9 position over here. So total 9 kind of things. Then if you want to find out the probability, then the probability is equal to occupied space of AB level of 3, so 3, and the remaining all the 6. So the total probability is equal to 3/6, which is equal to 1/2. Now in Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, the particles are distinguishable. Next we are coming to the probability. the probability of Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics can be represented by now this kind of equation. Now, here the pi represents the product. Now, here gi we are saying two terminologies. One is nj, nj is nothing but as occupancy, number of particles, occupancies, and gi is equal to degeneracies or nothing but as the particles occupied state, and pi represents the product. This g is equal to degeneracies values. So, gj, nj by nj. Now, here this nj is less than when compared to gj, because in Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, large number of particles are going to occupy. Therefore, the degeneracy is more. Therefore, gj is greater than nj. Now, little bit further mathematical calculations, then the probability wb can be represented by this kind of functions, and we apply, then this becomes maximum, we apply delta nb is equal to 0, and with further bit calculation by using string approximation and other things, finally, we arrived a kind of equation that log gi by nj minus alpha minus beta epsilon is equal to 0. So, finally, this relations. Now, here the ratio between nj by gj is considered to be factor fj, then e to the power minus alpha beta fj, where alpha and beta, they are temperature dependent terms. So, alpha can be represented by minus 1 by kt and beta is equal to minus alpha mu by kt. So, more or less this beta gives more explanation of the chemical potential, and alpha is a temperature dependent property. And another kind of statistics, Bose instant statistics, I already once again am repeating that if any particles are obey Bose instant laws, then you call bosons. These bosons, the terminology is given by Satyendranath Bose with help of Albert Einstein. We will look into the more details about the these Bose instant statistics. Now, the in earlier case, we have that particles are distinguishable. In case particles are indistinguishable, now this represents particle state, therefore, A is equal to B. In the earlier case Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, then the particles are two particles are there, A and B. Coming to the Fermi Bose instant statistics, the particles A is equal to B. Therefore, the occupations is equal to now here the 6 positions, and the 2 particles are occupied is equal to 3 positions, and the remaining particles A occupied by 3 positions, and therefore, 3 by 3 the probability is equal to 1. Now, here the particles are indistinguishable. With the Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, the particles are distinguishable, and the particles are indistinguishable, and particles with spins are integer spins, which is 0, 1, 2, and any number of particles can occupy per state. Then, if you look into the total probability, wj is equal to nj plus this thing, nj plus gi minus 1 by nj factorial into gj minus 1 factorial. Now, here nj is always greater than or equal to gi minus 1. So, gi here represents degeneracy, means number of particles occupied the particular states, where nj is equal to total number of atoms, particles, in other words. Now, this distribution can be represented by this kind of equation. Now, since we have a factorial kind of representation, therefore, finally, the probability of Bose instant is equal to can be represented by this kind of equation. Here, nj represents and number of particles are available and number of particles are occupied is equal to gi minus 1 factorial like this. When you apply further strings approximation and expansion in terms of logarithmic, we will get a kind of equation that nj by gj is equal to this kind of factor, where fj can be represented as distribution factor. The ratio is nothing but as distribution factor. If the value is equal to 1 by e to the power alpha plus beta epsilon I minus 1, where alpha represents 1 by kt and beta represents the kind of chemical potential. This chemical potential is more or less equal to the Fermi Dirac function only. Now, the another statistics, the last statistics we call Fermi Dirac statistics. This the pictorial diagram of the Fermi and is Dirac. According to that, these also particles are indistinguishable and we have particle states and 1, 2, 3. Now, here particles A is equal to B. Therefore, you are writing all A only. There is no B particle now here. Now, the occupancy, now probability is equal to the two particles occupied is not there. Therefore, we have 0 and the particles occupied states are 3 states, 1, 2, 3. You see that first one, second column, and third column like that. Therefore, the probability is equal to 0. Now, In thermodynamic statistics, these particles obey Pauli exclusive principle, whereas in the earlier case, Bose instant particles, they do not obey Pauli's exclusive principle. Now, look into this. Now, the probability is equal to Fermi Dirac probability is equal to J j by n j factor into J j minus 1, this kind of formula is there. Now, here G j is always greater than n j, means that the particles which are occupied is more when compared to the particles or n j. Now, finally, if you solve with string approximations and other things, we will arrive a equation kind of this. So, n j by G j is equal to 1 by this plus 1. The earlier case in Max Boltzmann Bose instant statistics, we have get minus 1. Here we are getting plus 1. So, in summary, we say the distribution factor f I, which is nothing but as ratio of n j by G j, is equal to this kind of equation. There alpha is equal to, once again we are representing that alpha is equal to temperature dependent property, and epsilon by j k, it represents a kind of Fermi Dirac function. Now, alpha is equal to this, here we are clearly given that alpha is equal to minus mu by k t, where mu is equal to chemical potential. This chemical potential is nothing but as Fermi Dirac function, can also related to Fermi Dirac function. Now, the ratio of n j by g j is equal to f j, and this kind of function. Now, the plus sign and minus sign also represents about the symmetric and antisymmetric cases. In case of minus, it is symmetric case, in case of plus, it represents antisymmetric functions. Now, symmetry and antisymmetry does not depend upon the plus or minus 1. The symmetric function psi is equal to, if psi is a function of r 1 comma r 2 comma r n, like the functions, and which can be represented by plus psi of interchanging from right r n to r 1, then it is called symmetric function, and psi is equal to minus psi into r n to r 1, that is called antisymmetric functions. This diagram will clearly gives the summary of both three statistics. Now, the Fermi Dirac statistics, we are getting this kind of line, and Maxwell Boltzmann statistics and Bose instant statistics curves are like this. At high temperature, all the functions are coincide to each other. Then, in Fermi Dirac statistics, the particles are occupied for each one particle level. Therefore, this distribution function like this, where here the particles are one particle state. Here, the many particles can occupied for particular state. Therefore, these functions are coming like this, and these function are coming like that. However, these three statistics may coincide at higher temperatures. Now, this Maxwell-Boltz statistics law, this is a classical limit when you compare to the Bose-Einstein statistics and Fermi Dirac statistics. Now, the chemical potential is main important, how the varies, we see that. This is expectation n, nothing but as number of particles, occupancy number versus epsilon by kBT. Now, the dispersion is more here minus kB by T. When more minus 2 kB by T, the dispersion is very less. Here, dispersion is very more. So, this is one of the significance of the comparison of the both three statistics. This statistical function, nothing, it represents more about the ensemble. Ensemble, nothing but as collection of large number of particles. It gives more information about this thing, state is called statistical factor versus energy. From this plot, we are clearly seeing that all these particles are going to coincide at higher temperatures. So, Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics function is equal to here, and Bose-Einstein statistics is equal to here, and Fermi Dirac statistics is equal to here. So, Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics is nothing but as a classical limit you consider, and these are kind of nothing but as a quantum kind of limits. Now, these are coincide at higher temperature. Now, once again we are summarizing that if particles obey classical statistics, then we call Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics. If particles obeys Bose-Einstein statistics, we call bosons, and the particles, if you obey Fermi Dirac statistics, we call fermions. Bosons are nothing but examples of particles should have in spin is 0 or integers, and Fermi Dirac statistics, the particles, the integral spin is half, 1 by 2. And Bose particles, example boson particles are photons like that, and Fermi Dirac particles are examples are electron, protons, neutrons, alpha particles, etc. Now, coming to the applications principle, Fermi Dirac statistics, now it is a good representation of Fermi Dirac statistics will explain you about the free electrons in a semiconductor or metal, how they like. In Fermi Dirac statistics, this plot, if you show that at energy is equal to 0, then your thermodynamic status is equal to 1 maximum. Then at absolute temperature, it all are occupied. When temperature increases, this plot shows that when temperature increases, the blue line represents when more temperature. At absolute temperature, maximum occupancy is equal to 1. As temperature increases, this is decreasing like this. So, this is more temperature and this is at absolute temperature. You can note that if I already told you that the chemical potential can also represented as Fermi temperature. If T is equal to T Fermi temperature, then we are getting this kind of plot. If temperature is more than Fermi temperature, then drastically decreasing the function. So, based on this kind of this, then people have explained about the free electron theory and metals and semiconductors and other things. If you look into the plot of this is one of the applications of the Fermi Dirac statistics. If you plot function versus f, then with increasing temperature, this is given clearly. When temperature increases, this function is kind of oscillating like this. Now, with high temperature, now coming to low temperature, this is a low temperature picture. Now, coming to the high temperature, this is changing. The main noteworthy aspect here is at temperature increasing also, the point is oscillating over here one only. It is not changing exactly. So, the occupancy is more, means that the number of particles per particular state, one particle is occupying, not more than that. So, this is equal to 1, it is not changing one. When the other picture, when you look into that, then this representation at absolute temperature, as temperature increases, the function is also changing. However, but at higher temperatures, all functions are merging. Another noteworthy aspect over here is all intersection is equal to 0.5, exactly if you look into that 0.5. So, the density states or number of particles versus the chemical potential, if you plot like that, we have 0.5, means that every state is occupied by one particle. This has given more explanation on this. Another good example of the Fermi Dirac statistics is explanation of the white draft theory. White draft, if you look into the pictures, we have this is a stellar experiment of that. Then if you plot the brightness versus the temperature, then we have divided the white drafts, which are less temperature. More bright is more temperature. Now, you are seeing a kind of clusters like that. Now, if you look into that, the temperature decreases as brightness is also increases, luminescence is increases with increasing the temperature. With increasing the temperature, the luminescence is increases. Now, this is a red giant and this white drafts. Now, white drafts are good example of the Fermi Dirac statistics. Consider that white drafts is deionized hydrogen gases. They have large number of electrons and it is a deionized hydrogen gases. Now, Chandrasekhar has given, who is an Indian astrophysicist, has given the relation between the mass of the white star and the sun. So, the relation is equal to mass of the white star is less or equal to 1.4 m, mass of the white star is less or equal to 1.4 m s, your m s is assigned, this is called Chandrasekhar limit. From that, mass can be evaluated for the white gains. So, the Fermi Dirac statistics, one of the most good example to explain of the white drafts. Now, in summary, Boltzmann statistics, Bose instant statistics, Fermi Dirac statistics. If particles obey Bose instant statistics, called bosons. If particles obey Fermi Dirac statistics, called fermions. Bose statistics, they are indistinguishable and they are distinguishable, and these integral spins is equal to half. Now, spin does not matter in Boltzmann statistics and bosons. We have spin matters, and the spin value is equal to 0, 1, 2, and whereas fermions, the spin is equal to half. Then bosons are the examples of the helium gases or photons, and fermions are electrons, protons, neutrons, etcetera. And this is symmetric function, Bose statistics is a symmetric function, whereas this is equal to anti-symmetric functions. Einstein found that when the temperature is high, they have like ordinary gases. However, when temperature is very low, they will get together at lowest quantum state. This is called Bose instant statistics. This is one of the good example of the Bose instant condensation, where we see that thing. As temperature decrease, as temperature, if you plot density versus temperature, then density remains constant up to this point and drastically decreases. So, this temperature is called a lambda transition temperature. When temperature is decreasing, going to like this and found to be like the end of this. Now, more good example is this. If you plot Cv versus temperature, then we get this kind of plot. So, this temperature is equal to a lambda temperatures. Now, this is also transient temperature, where transient temperature is equal to 2.17, a change from superfluid to normal state. This was explained by Bose instant statistics. As the temperature is reduced from 4.2 Kelvin towards the lower temperature, the liquid boils vigorously, and 2.17 means exactly the lambda transition temperature, it suddenly stops. Now, boiling is here from this temperature. Once again, I am repeating some of the important points from the over the talk. Particles are classified into three categories. We have seen that Bose instant statistics, Fermi Dirac statistics. If particles obeys Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, you call Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, and if particles obey the Bose instant statistics, called Bose instant distribution, and if particles obey Fermi-Dirac distribution, called Fermi-Dirac distribution. Now, in Boltzmann statistics, the particles are indistinguishable, and case of Bose instant statistics, particles are indistinguishable, and Bose instant statistics, particles are indistinguishable, Fermi-Dirac statistics, particles are indistinguishable, whereas Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics, particles are distinguishable. The examples of the Bose instant statistics are photons, and the examples of the Fermi-Dirac statistics are electrons, protons, neutrons, etcetera. Then, the Bose instant statistics, the wave function is symmetric, and whereas Fermi-Dirac statistics, the wave function is antisymmetric. And both Bose instant statistics and Fermi-Dirac statistics leads to the Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics at higher temperature. These are the main important points.
మా కార్యక్రమాలపై మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు ఆహ్వానిస్తున్నాం. మీ సూచనలు సలహాలు మాకు తెలియచేయవలసిన చిరునామా: డైరెక్టర్, ఆడియో విజువల్ ప్రొడక్షన్ అండ్ రీసెర్చ్ సెంటర్, డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ ఓపెన్ యూనివర్సిటీ, ప్రొఫెసర్ జి రామరెడ్డి మార్క్, రోడ్ నంబర్ 46, జూబ్లీ హిల్స్, హైదరాబాద్ 50003.